Okay, good morning. We are on to grade 10 mathematics, and then this morning we will be looking at equal intercepts. It's a follow-up from our work on formal geometry, and then our textbook of reference is the New General Mathematics for SS1. We are on page, depending on the iteration of the textbook you're using, we are on page 40. Or just look for on your textbook where you have equal intercepts, 2.5 equal intercepts, and just after that there's a theorem. So we'll start by trying to develop the concept of equal intercepts. Remember that from your GSS, if I have two lines and I have a line cutting it, we say that this line is called the transversal. Transversal, that's what is called a transversal. So let's call that line, say AB, let's call it XY, let's call it PQ, and then let's call this space, which is your intercept. This essentially is your intercept. Let's call that VW. So what's actually happening here is that these are two lines and there is a transversal cutting. Whenever you have a transversal cutting a line or cutting two lines, a transversal will essentially cut a pair of lines. A transversal will essentially cut a pair of what? Lines. So if it cuts this, what you're going to get is called the intercept. It's called the word intercept. And what an intercept does is that it divides this line into three parts. So you're going to have this one, and this one as parts of that line. All right. But over to the main matter. If three or more parallel lines, the intercept theorem applies to parallel lines. So you imagine three parallel lines. So I'll read and I'll try to draw. It's called theorem 8. It's called theorem 8. It says that if three or more lines, more parallel lines, cut off equal intercepts. Cut off what? Equal intercepts on a transversal. If three or more lines which are parallel cut off equal intercepts on a transversal, then they cut off equal intercept on another transversal. The implication is this: if these lines are equal, if I draw another transversal, this line, this, if this space is this intercept, and this an intercept, this another intercept. He's saying that if this intercepts, one, intercept two, if they are equal, it will be the same effect that will be created in intercept three and intercept four. I see that. That's the implication of the theorem. So this intercept will be equal to this intercept, and it will cause equal corresponding effect on the opposite side. So the implication is this: if this space here is A, and this space is what, A, it will cut off B here, and this space also will be what? B. That's the concept of equal intercepts. I don't know that message is passed. If that is passed, then we will go straight ahead to exercise 2F to look at the implication of this rule. All right, so let's start. Look at exercise 2F. I trust you have your pencil, your ruler. Remember that that's the standing protocol for our class. You can't draw with a biro, so please make sure you have your pencil and ruler with you. This is the first question. There is question A. That's question 1A. So let's treat question 1. And we're treating A there. Look at that. This is what you have. Cutting off equal intercepts such that it applies only to parallel lines. So please take note of that. Such that this is equal to this. So you're asking this is 3.1. what would this part be? What would this part be? K will be equal to 3.1. What's the reason? Equal intercepts. That's all. K will be equal to 3.1. What's the reason? Equal intercept. By reason of the theorem, if this is equal to this, then it will cut off corresponding equalities on the other side. All right, so that takes care of question one. Let's look at B. Now in question B, now look at this question B. If this is N, this is 3, this is 3, this is 2.5, this is N, and this is 2.5. What will M be? M will be equal to 2.5. What's the reason for that? Equal intercept. I see that. What will N be equal to? N will be equal to what? 3. What's the reason? Equal intercept. Are we together? So you see that the theorem is quite simple and easy to appreciate. So with that in mind, I will now leave you to try your hands on question C, D, and E. Question C, D, and E. All right. Okay, see what's happening in this question. Look at it. Question E. This is 3, So what would this one be? Remember that this equal intercept cuts off equally here. This is equal to this. So this there are two portions. So U is two portions of 3. This U is two portions. So U will be equal to 3 times 2. This is 3. If this is 3, if I just stretch this forward, this will also be 3, and this will also be 3. I said it. So 3 plus 3 will be equal to 6. So this is 6. So that's why that U will be what? 6, right? All right, let's go. Question 2. This is what you have in question 2. This is D, this is B. Now, you are told to find the ratio of find AD over DB. What is AD? AD over DB. AD is what? Now look at this. Each of these will cut off equal intercepts here. I seen that. Each of these cut off equal intercepts here. So AD is 2A. DB is what? A. So the answer is what? 2. Do you understand? The questions are very straightforward. Don't think too much. Don't carry your brain and begin to think unnecessarily. The questions are very straightforward. Question 3. Now, in question 3, you're giving a very interesting diagram. Very, very interesting diagram. I hope I'll be able to draw it.
No.
All right, so watch this. I seen that. So and all of these are equal. I seen that. Five divisions, they are all what? Equal. Okay, they say this is Y, this is Z, this is Q, this is P. Now we are told that what is the ratio A? What is the ratio of what? XP over XY. XP, where is X? XP, two portions. XP is two portions. Look at it. One, two. Over XY. XY is how many portions? One, two, three, four, five. So the answer is 2/5. B. It says, what is the ratio of what? ZQ over QX. ZQ over QX. Now look at ZQ. ZQ is one portion, just one. Over QX. QX is 1, 2, 3, 4, four portions. So that'll be 1/4. Now, C says, if XP, now XP is equal to 9. What would XY be? XY will now be what? Look at it. XP is 2/5. So XP over XY will be equal to 2/5, which will be equal to what? Sorry, XP. I think that's XP. Which will be equal to what? 9/what? XY, which we are looking for, X. Let's call it X. We don't know what XY is. Or we can just call it XY. So XY will now be equal to what? 5 × 9/2, which will be what? 22.5. All right. Let's look at D. In D, we are told that ZQ is equal to 3.5. This is CN. So what is QX? Now, ZQ is ZQ, QX is 4 times of what? ZP. So QX will be equal to 4 times of what? 3.5, and that will be what? 14 cm. So that's for question 3. That's for question 3.